In this week's science lesson, we are going to be learning about density. If something is more dense, that means it is packed together and heavier than something that is less dense. And it's easy for us to see that solid things, like this cart right here, solid things are hard and heavy. They are more dense than air. Can I push my hand through this cart and just punch right through it? No, it's solid. Can I push my hand through air and punch right through it? Yes, it's a gas and it is not dense. Well, did you know that cold water is more dense than hot water? I have two containers of water right here. This one is very warm. It would be a good temperature for taking a bath or a shower. And we're gonna fill up two of these cups with warm water. But first, I'm gonna add a little bit of food coloring. This demonstration works without food coloring, but it's more difficult to see. It's a lot easier to tell what's going on if we color the water. So I'm going to put 3 drops of yellow into this cup, and 3 drops of yellow into this cup over here. And then we are going to add our warm water. And because our warm water is less dense, it tends to want to rise. We're gonna fill the water all the way up to the very top of the cup. And then we're gonna do the same over here. Just like hot air balloons tend to rise because the air inside them is less dense than the air around them, the same thing happens with water. Warm water rises and cold water sinks. I have here a container of ice cold water and we're going to color the cold water blue. 2 drops of food coloring in this cup, 2 drops of food coloring in this cup. And now we'll take out our ice cold water and fill up these two cups with cold water. And now comes the fun part. We are going to layer these cups in an opposite way. We're going to have cold on top of warm here and warm on top of cold over here. And then the experiment or the question that we are asking is what happens when we remove the barrier between these cups and let the water mix? Will they mix together and make green? Will they stay layered or will they trade places? So as I'm setting this up, I want you to be making predictions about what you think will happen when we remove the lids. So here is our experiment. We have our cups set up with warm on top on one side and cold on top on the other side, and you have enough information to make a prediction because you know that warm water wants to rise and cold water wants to sink. So first, we're going to remove the barrier right here between these two cups. Watch closely. I recommend having 2 people to do this because it is tricky to do with just 1 person trying to balance the cups and remove it at the same time. But you can see that the cups stayed the same. We have yellow on top of blue because the warm water wants to be up and it's already up. The blue water wants to be down and it's already down. Now we're going to try the same thing over here with these cups. And they are mixing together. You can see that within just a few seconds, the cups have turned green. And they've turned green because that warm water that was on the bottom wanted to rise, it wanted to go up, and that cold water that was on the top wanted to sink, wanted to go down. We have a dramatic difference in color here, but we also have a dramatic difference in temperature. I can feel through the plastic that this is hot water. I can feel through the plastic that this is cold water. But if I place my hands here and here, the water temperature feels the same, not hot, not cold, just lukewarm, because this water has mixed together to make warm. One neat thing that you can do to take this a level deeper is to experiment with changing the temperature of the water. I told you that this water was ice cold and that our warm water was about a comfortable temperature for taking a bath, but what would happen if you had a smaller difference in temperature? What if the cold water was 40 degrees Fahrenheit and the warm water was 45 degrees Fahrenheit, and they were relatively close in temperature? Would they mix to turn green sooner, or would it take longer? What is the relationship between the temperature difference and how long it takes for the water to mix? Because these cups will eventually turn green, just like these ones over here did. How long it takes depends on the temperature, and you can find out exactly what that relationship is by doing some careful experimenting and then recording your data. If you would like to check out our science fair guide, go into the description and there's a link where we walk you through how to make this into a full science investigation or a science fair project. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration, and as always, come back next week and join us for another one. And a special thank you to our Navigator patron, Noelani Nomiyama. If you would like to support the creation of these videos, check us out at patreon.com/sciencemom. We'll see you next week. And the other question that I always get asked by kids is, how are you going to get the water out of the cups? You can turn them sideways, and just like cracking an egg, whoop, spill the water out. Or, and I think this is even a little bit more fun, you can offset the cups so that they're not lined up, and then blah, 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 the water from the top cup will all fall out, and then you can just pour out the water from the bottom cup.